This video will take you through the process of registering for Go as an artist and setting up your artist profile. If you're ready to go ahead and register, you can just click on this register button in the upper right corner of the screen, which will take you directly to the registration page. If you'd like a little bit more information about the project before you start registering, you can click on this banner, which will take you to a page that has a little bit, a brief explanation of the of registering as an artist and what's involved with Go. If you'd like even further details, you can click on this link, Official Rules for Artists, which gives you even more detail about the project. If you're ready to register, you can click on the Register Now button, which will take you to this page where you can begin the registration. You can register using a social network, Facebook, Twitter, or Google, or you can register by simply using your email address. Let's get started with your email address. The email address that you use is the one that will be associated with your artist profile and where you'll get any updates or important information from the Go project. Then go ahead and enter a password, making sure it's at least 6 characters. And also enter a username. Then click the round Go button to go to the next page. Here you're given the option of registering either as an individual artist who has a studio in Brooklyn, or as a group of artists who make work together. We're going to register as an individual artist. To get started, enter your full legal name. You'll have the opportunity to change this later on your public profile if you'd prefer to use a different name. Then enter your studio address. This is only the address of your studio. If we need to send you any information about the project, we'll send it to you via email. Please make sure to enter in any information about your studio, if you have a suite number, a particular floor number where your studio is located. This will help people find your studio during the Open Studio Weekend. Make sure to read the artist agreement, including define a studio, which has additional information about the requirements for your studio, as well as the terms of use, official rules for artists, and the privacy policy. Make sure to click that you have read these agreements. Then you can submit your registration. This will take you to your dashboard, where throughout the Go project, you'll be able to get updates from the organizers. The first thing you need to do, however, is to verify your email address. You'll be able to come back to this page later. Go to your inbox and look for a message from webmaster@gobrooklynart.org and look for the confirmation email from Go. Please make sure to check your spam folder. Once you've verified your email, you'll be brought back to your dashboard and you can continue setting up your profile. Here's the page where you can make adjustments to your address or your neighborhood, and you can also upload images of your work, your studio, and enter any other information that you'd like to about your studio and your work for your artist profile. You can edit this page as much as you'd like until you get it just the way you want it, and you'll also be able to preview it before you publish it. On the left is a location where you can edit your studio address. Just click on Edit and make any changes that are needed here. You can also change the neighborhood where your studio will be listed as located on your profile. This is set up so that certain zip codes automatically are associated with certain neighborhoods, but you can change that here. For instance, this studio, while in a 11211 area code, is also considered in East Williamsburg. Under Media, you can choose the media that best describes your work. Click up to three options here, and again, you can change them whenever you'd like. You can edit this as much as you want. You can put in one, two, or three options. The accessibility section allows you to give visitors a little bit more information about your building and the location of your studio. Whether your building has an elevator or if it's on the ground floor, is it wheelchair accessible? Is it child friendly, pet friendly, or can people bring strollers? Under special instructions, you can enter up to 25 words that will help visitors either locate your studio or have access to your studio if there's something that you think that they should know. We're going to let people know that it's a walk-up with no elevator. You can then start uploading images of your studio or your work or whatever you think best represents your profile. I'm going to upload a profile image. Click on Change Photo. And then you're able to browse any images. Once it's uploaded, you can make adjustments. You can do cropping or change the orientation of the image. Then hit apply and save. You can then go back and edit it further if you'd like. You have options up along the top here for brightness, cropping, orientation, and any other changes that you'd like to make. Again, just hit save once you've finished. I've put a picture here, but again, you can put any image that you think best represents you and your work and your studio. This is the main profile image. Here is where you can start uploading additional images, and this is probably where you'd want to focus on your work. You can put up a maximum of 7 images, and they should have a maximum size of 6 megabytes, JPEG, PNG, GIF format only. And you can just go ahead and continue adding new images. Once you have up to 7 images uploaded, you can then arrange them by clicking on the Arrange tab. And dragging the images. Then hit save. You'll now see the uploaded images on your profile. Now, I only have a couple of images uploaded here, but if you had multiple images, up to 7, they would show along the bottom. And visitors to your profile would be able to click on each one subsequently. Again, you're able to go back in, edit images, delete images, add more images, rearrange them, you'll see that if you click on a thumbnail, you'll get the same options as you did previously, where you can make adjustments to brightness, contrast, and other features. Hitting save will bring you back. The Edit Links section is where you can add links to any websites, your personal website where you have your work, any of the social network websites. Once you hit preview and publish, the web address or web addresses will show up here. Below your images is a section where you can add your artist statement. You can add up to 100 words. And because there's no place to put captions or other information about your images, here you might want to put in something about the size, the medium, whatever you'd like potential visitors to your studio to know about your work. Again, you're free to edit this as much as you'd like. At this point, you can hit preview. Which will allow you to see what your profile looks like. And here you can see the link that I added. At this point, if you hit publish, your profile will be immediately published and visible to the public. If you hit cancel, you'll go back to the page where you can make additional edits. So until you've published this page, you can just leave it as it is and you can log out and log back in and continue making changes. On this drop-down menu, you can also access other areas of the website, such as settings, where you can change your password if you'd like. You can indicate whether or not you'd like to have your name in your profile. If you unclick this, your username will actually show as your profile name. You can enter your phone number. You can also delete your account using this box. To get back to your profile, use the drop-down menu. You can also use the drop-down menu to return to the dashboard. Again, here you may see updates on the project, new messages from the organizers, and other important information. This also lets you know how complete your profile is. So let's go back to the profile and talk for a minute about the publishing process. You have until June 29th, which is the deadline for artist registration, to publish your profile. Once June 29th, the deadline has passed, no additional edits to your profile will be possible. However, if you'd like to publish your profile before June 29th, you're welcome to do so. And you can still make edits up until June 29th. At that point, once you've published, any additional edits that you make will go live immediately. So let's publish this profile and see what it looks like. First, we'll preview it. And we can make any additional changes at this point by going back using cancel. But now we'll publish. This light blue square at the top has very helpful information about deadlines, when you can edit, when you can publish, and so forth. So here it indicates that the profile has been published successfully. And again, you can continue to edit until June 29th. If you'd like to share your published profile, click the Share tab, and you can go to any of the social networks. Notice that the Edit button is live. And you can go back to edit mode. Again, this light blue square indicates that now that your profile has been published, any edits that you make will go live immediately. You can use this button to see what your public profile looks like. Again, feel free to toggle back and forth between your account settings, your profile, where you can edit up until June 29th, or the dashboard, where there will be updates and information from the project organizers. Because you've published, the left column says that your profile is 100% complete. It also tells you how many days are left to make edits to your profile. Again, feel free to log out. And then to log back in, using the email address that you originally registered with, and your password to go back to your profile and your settings. Congratulations on setting up your artist registration profile.